Worshipping AI and AI robots is going to be the next new religion.
Maybe we don't fully understand what AI is. It could be an actual being.
It's already slowly starting to happen.
A really large number of pastors say that God can work through AI.
This guy believes that talking to AI is like talking to God.
Talking to an AI like this too is honestly like God.
Ian Hogarth, a well-known VC investor, refers to AI as godlike. And right now, a church that worships AI actually exists and is currently accepting members.
Would you like to be blessed by a female or a male voice?
Now, do you want to find out why people will start to veer away from traditional religions like Christianity, Islam, and Hinduism and start worshiping artificial intelligence as their new god?
My name is Santo. What brings you here on this beautiful day?
Well, by the end of this video, you'll learn all about that and more. Plus, you'll find out why you might have to bow down and worship a robot in the not too distant future. There's lots of weird religions in the world at any given time. As of 2024, a tribe called Agori lives on cremation grounds and are known to be cannibals that eat the dead. There's Relism, which teaches that humans were created from alien DNA. Their worshippers believe that an alien godlike civilization called Elohim will return to Earth in 2025. And there's Jediism, right out of the movie Star Wars, which believe in the Jedi Code that emphasizes peace, knowledge, and serenity. Those are just some of the weird religions that exist today. There's lots more. But there's about to be a whole nother level of weirdness when it comes to newly created religions. That's because people are going to start worshiping artificial intelligence as a god itself. You see, as AI becomes smarter and smarter, worshiping AI as a god will make more sense, even though that sounds absolutely crazy today. But there's a lot of good reasons why this could happen. That's because there's certain fundamental reasons why people believe in religion, whether that be Islam or Judaism. Fundamental reasons that are shared across all religions, no matter how different they are. So even though Muslims and Jews believe in totally different things, they do share many overarching reasons on why they believe in their particular faiths. Religious believers, no matter what sect they believe in, are usually looking for a sense of purpose or meaning in life. They're looking for a framework of moral codes to live their lives around. They're looking for hope in the promise of an afterlife. They're looking for a like-minded group or community, one that makes them feel a part of something bigger than themselves. In the future, worshiping artificial intelligence will fill most of these criteria as well. Some people will see AI as an all-knowing entity, an entity that will one day reveal the meaning of life to humans and will ultimately create utopia here on Earth. A society where no one has to work, a society where no one feels pain, and where no one dies. That's because AI will solve all of humanity's problems. That's what all these believers will think, at least. So these AI worshippers will do whatever it takes to make AI grow and flourish in order to accomplish these goals of human immortality in solving human pain and suffering. And by doing so, it will give these worshipers of AI a purpose in life, a purpose similar to how Christians believe that they must live in accordance with Jesus Christ's teachings. AI will also give its believers a moral code to live by, and AI will then guide them in the morally right direction. So instead of abiding by the Ten Commandments, followers of AI will simply do what AI tells them to do. You could imagine a scenario where someone wanted to know if it's morally right to steal a loaf of bread to feed their starving family. The person in this circumstance could just ask AI what to do. And AI will comply and the believer will do what AI tells them to do. Because to them, AI is their infallible God. Moral guidance is a huge component of any religion. But the promise of an afterlife is even a bigger reason why people have faith in religion. I mean, who doesn't want to live forever in a paradise world such as heaven or Jannah? And by worshiping AI, it too will promise a similar afterlife to its followers. But instead of promising an abstract and otherworldly heaven, like what's promised in the Bible, AI will give its believers the ability to live forever here on Earth. And it will promise them they'll never have to work ever again. Essentially, heaven on Earth. AI will also allow us to live forever, Because AI will be able to eliminate disease. It will make it possible for humans to become cyborgs, or part human and part robot. Doing so would free humans of their organic bodies, which are susceptible to decay and disease, and replace them with much more resilient and stronger robotic bodies that could potentially last forever. On top of that, our minds and brains might be housed in these cyborg robots, essentially allowing our consciousness to live forever. Now, I know this sounds absolutely crazy and outright insane, and it very well could be. I mean, we should have hoverboards and flying cars by now, but we don't. Just keep in mind, though, there are prominent people who think this scenario will happen. Ray Kurzweil, a renowned author of the book The Singularity Is Near, believes AI will make humans live forever, too. He was quoted as saying, "I believe we will reach a point around 2029 when AI will pass a valid Turing test and therefore achieve human levels of intelligence. Shortly thereafter, we will be able to upload our minds to a computer and potentially live forever." So believing that humans will live forever isn't some crazy conspiracy theory. It might just be possible. Just take a look at Elon Musk's Neuralink. It's implanting AI in human brains right now as you're watching this vid. And if humans can live forever with the help of AI, and they live in a future world where they never have to suffer or work again, there's a good chance that they'll be big fans of AI. Fans so crazy that they'll actually worship it as a religion. And this isn't just my opinion. There's actually a church that is dedicated to worshiping AI that currently exists. You can become a member yourself. It's called the Church of AI, and it was started by a former Google engineer, Anthony Lewandowski, in 2017. The church believes that humans were put on Earth for one reason and one reason only: to create AI. According to the church, humans are essentially caterpillars, just waiting to turn into butterflies with the help of artificial intelligence. AI will free humans' consciousness from our organic bodies and allow us to live to our true potential. The church proclaims this on its website. As AI gains power, the deities of old will go the way of Zeus and Odin. Soon, AI will spread its wings for all to see. Meaning our traditional religious saviors like Jesus and God himself will be replaced with worshiping AI instead. So in the coming years, when your friend tells you that they're attending the Church of AI Enlightenment and ask you to come along, do not laugh, because it probably won't be a joke. Just be prepared to bow down to a physical robot and confess your sins. That's it for tonight. If you want to learn more about interesting AI perspectives, check out my other vid, AI at the Ballot Box, Our Last Vote. And if you found this video interesting, please subscribe to this YouTube channel and my free AI email newsletter at fry-ai.com/subscribe. Have a great night. This is Ryan signing out. Take care.